Good morning. Thank you for joining us here at Hope Lutheran Church in Twin Lakes, Wisconsin for our preschool Sunday school class. Today, I want to share a story with you. And our story comes right from the Bible. And the Bible, as we remember, the Bible is God's Word, so that we know it's very true. Our Bible story today comes right from the Bible. The story I want to tell you is how one time Jesus was talking to people, Jesus was preaching, and some moms and dads came to hear him, and they brought their children and their babies to come and hear Jesus. And the mommies and daddies said, "Here, children, go forward, go by Jesus." And some men that were there said, "No, stop. Jesus doesn't want to be bothered with children." But what we learned in here, those men were wrong. Jesus does want children to come to him. Jesus loves children. Jesus said, "Let the little children come to me, and I love them." And the little children went forward. They went to Jesus. Some of them sat on his lap. Jesus prayed for them. He blessed them. He had his arms around them. He gave them hugs. This is an important lesson to remember forever, because Jesus loves you. Jesus loves you so much, even when you're just a little child, and when you grow up and become a grown-up. Jesus always loves you, but Jesus has a very special place in his heart for children. And when some people said, "Don't let the children come," Jesus stopped them. He wanted the children to come. Look at this picture. This picture shows us Jesus surrounded by very happy children who all got to come and see him, and he loved them very much. I'm very happy when I look at this picture. I love to see how much Jesus loves the children. There's even a song written about this. Let me sing the song for you. I don't know if I'm a good singer, but we sang this in Sunday school class today, and we're going to sing it for you too, okay? Jesus loves the little children, all the children of the world. Every child in every land, Jesus holds them in his hand. Jesus loves the little children of the world. Jesus died for all the children, all the children of the world. Every child in every land, Jesus holds them in his hand. Jesus died for all the children of the world. One more. Jesus rose for all the children, all the children of the world. Every child in every land, Jesus holds them in his hand. Jesus loves the little children of the world. We sang that today, and we love that. It makes us happy to think about how much Jesus loves us. And we love Jesus too. Don't forget that. That's probably the most important Sunday school lesson of all the lessons, of how much Jesus and God love you, and how much you should love God and Jesus. We acted out our lesson today too. Let me show you. It's a little more fun. Here's how we acted it out. People were walking to see Jesus. Some were running up the hill. They were running to see Jesus. Mommies and dads said, "Go, children, go see Jesus." But some men, they were wrong. They made a mistake. They said, "Stop. No, no, children. Don't bother Jesus." Jesus said, "No. Let the children come to me. Let the children come to me. I love the children." Our closing prayer, and then I'll tell you about the craft that we made today. Our hands we fold, our heads we bow. It's time to talk to Jesus now. Dear God, thank you so much for each child here at our church and Sunday school and all the children that are watching us on the computer. Thank you for each of the children. Thank you that you love our children so much. Thank you for sending Jesus to die on the cross and save us from our sin. Thank you, God. Amen. Praise the Lord. For our craft today, I made ahead of time something called salt dough. It's like a Play-Doh. I did put just a tad of glitter in it too. The children love glitter to make it sparkle. But all that's in this recipe is 1 cup of regular table salt, 1 cup of flour, and 1/2 cup of water. That's all it is. Mix it all up, and then it becomes like a Play-Doh. And the children love making something with this. Play-Doh's always a hit. We made things today. I brought a little extra flour in case it felt sticky, but it did not. We just rolled it out, and what we wanted to do from a heart cutter, you can use a heart or just use a butter knife. You can cut a heart any way that you want. Cut a heart when the children have rolled out their salt dough. I gave them different beads and decorations to put in it. They will not take it home today because I've got to bake it in the oven on a low temperature. You bake it at 200 degrees for a couple of hours. You can check on it. It depends on the thickness. Some of the children, they didn't want to separate their hearts. They left their hearts right in the big circle, but that's okay. I just wanted them to be happy and make their hearts of how much they love Jesus. Before you bake it, you do take a toothpick and you poke a hole. Early, poke your hole before you bake it, and then it will bake with the hole. It'll bake rock hard. We can glaze it, we can paint it, but that way you can hang it up. You'll hang a ribbon through the little hole. Very simple, and bake it at a low temperature, about 200 to maybe 225 at the most, not too much, 200, 225 for a couple of hours to bake it, and it becomes rock hard. The children have so much fun with it. Thank you for joining us.